David Brewster here with another three for all, and this is three Joe Satriani licks from 1987. And of course, Joe Satriani is a total, you know, guitar legend, and kind of just erupted on the scene, you know, in the mid to late 1980s. And you know, he's been a huge influence on me. And you know, I started playing because of Van Halen. You know, got into Randy Rhoads, got into Malmsteen, got into Steve Vai, and then when I learned that Joe Satriani taught Steve Vai and a whole bunch of other, you know, guitarists, you know, my sights were set on him. I thought, who is the guy that taught Steve Vai? Because, I mean, Steve Vai still blows my mind. But back then, I mean, Steve Vai completely blew my mind. And then I thought, wait, Satriani taught him? And it left a huge impression on me because I realized he could play and shred and, you know, release all this instrumental music, but he could also teach. And that was a big influence as far as me becoming more interested in music theory. You know, scales and modes and arpeggios and composition and the whole thing. So definitely, I'm a huge Satriani fan. The licks in this lesson actually come from a live bootleg from New York City in 1987. It was at the Limelight, and that's kind of a famous, you know, gig for Satriani because this was in July of 1987. And that album right there, you know, Surfing with the Alien, came out in October of 1987. So this was right before Satriani kind of single-handedly changed the face of rock guitar, brought, you know, instrumental rock music back into popularity. You know, it was like the first time in I don't know how many decades, you know, that an instrumental rock album hit the charts. You know, that hadn't happened since like surf guitar, like the Ventures and some of those groups. So definitely Satriani, you know, he's a legend, and he's done a lot for not only, you know, other guitarists, you know, Steve Vai and Alex Skolnick and Charlie Hunter and some of these different players that studied with him, but he also just influenced, you know, thousands, if not tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of other guitarists, you know, whipping out all these modal, you know, progressions and really, you know, out there kind of music approaches and advanced harmony, advanced theory, you know, combining elements of jazz and classical and all these different styles together. But under all the complexity, Joe definitely has a big bluesy side, and you can hear these really cool and expressive and just gritty, you know, blues ideas, you know, something like this. The first lick from this live footage, you know, speaking of bluesy and expressive phrases, during the footage, the band stops after one of the songs, and then Joe just starts playing this unaccompanied solo and starts playing all these different licks and ideas, and this is one of the phrases, you know, from that part of the show. And even though nobody's playing behind him, it is kind of based around A7, and it sounds like this. Cool. And it starts with a step and a half bend on E, and he's bending up basically to that G note. And this is kind of a signature, you know, phrase. I've heard Joe play different versions of this lick, you know, through the years. And one more time there. Really cool, and I love that big bend in the beginning. But here's Joe playing it from 1987. Alright, the next lick comes from the same part of the show where the band stopped and Joe's just playing this variety of licks and phrases. And this is a melodic motif based around A natural minor. It's not really a lick, it's almost like a riff, but then at the end he does this really cool like slip and slide move, something like this. And it's really cool because he's kind of flirting with A minor and A minor 6, or you can almost think of that as like a, you know, F major over A. Rock that kind of has that tonality too, but he's playing it in a melodic way like that, and then start on the F, interesting the way he comes down. So right there, you want to slide this G up to A, and then you're going to slide D up to E on the A string, and then slide that E down to C, and then you're going to slide B up to C on the A, and then you're going to do a pull off D, C to the open A. And then right there, slide into the 5th fret on the low E string into that A note. So that part, one more time. And it's cool the way he kind of finishes that phrase. Joe playing this back in 1987. The next lick is this mix and match arpeggio idea, and he kind of mixes two arpeggios in the beginning and then finishes with like a D blues phrase. And that's a blues scale phrase in D. But it looks like this. So it starts with this really high C bent up to a D, so you're just bending it up a whole step. And then he comes down a D minor arpeggio right there. And you're going to slide that D basically down to an A right there. And then right there, he's kind of flirting with a B flat major 7 arpeggio. So slowly. And right here, he kind of dips into like the D blues scale and does this. So there he's grabbing that D note, bends it up a step and a half to that F way up there. Together. Really cool lick. I really couldn't put together a Joe Satriani 3 for all and not show some crazy, you know, legato lick or a workout or a warm-up. And I have had some requests from viewers, you know, asking for legato, you know, exercises and phrases. And I definitely got into legato, you know, from studying Eddie Van Halen. I saw Eddie, you know, in interviews mention Alan Holdsworth, and I checked out Alan, you know, which completely blew my mind. And then when I finally heard Satriani, you know, I was just hooked. I thought, okay, I really want to work on legato. I really like this fluid, you know, kind of liquid sound. And I've worked on picking a lot, but I've worked on legato a lot. You know, exercises, licks, phrases, and just, you know, playing scales and different things using legato. So this is an E Dorian based workout or warm up. And we're going to start, you know, basically with the low E string and then cruise our way up to, you know, the 12th fret there on the high E string. And we're going to use kind of a connecting pattern of these kind of linked, you know, octaves or scale shapes on the way up. And then we're going to descend using a different sequence of notes and a different pattern. And this is something Satriani does all the time. And it took me a long time to really understand and notice that he would travel along the fretboard using one shape and then reverse the pattern and go, you know, descending or go back down using a different, you know, sequence of notes or a different pattern. And at first it was confusing, but then once I kind of learned how to do it, I thought, hey, I think I see how he's doing that. So it looks like this. And then slowly, what we're doing is this. And right there, notice how I'm only picking the first note on each new string. Something like that. When you get right there and play that F sharp, you know, G and A. And you're going to start it again. And right there, we're basically mimicking the same thing that you had on the D string, this part. But you're doing it on the B string. There, basically just go up, you know, B, C sharp, D, and then slide up to that E note. And then when you're ready to go back down, we're going to do this shape. So one more time there. Fret hand strength to get those notes to come out, you know, loud and proud, and that's very hard to do. So one more time, kind of slow. Didn't come from the live footage from 87, and this really isn't a lick. This is actually the intro to the song Turkey Man, which is kind of an obscure Satriani moment. And in 2000, when he released the album Engines of Creation, he included, you know, a limited run of these EPs, Additional Creations, I believe it was called. And I don't have that EP, but I've heard Turkey Man before. I've actually worked on this with a few students over the years. And if you've seen John Petrucci's classic, you know, Rock Discipline, you know, instructional video, he shared a picking exercise in that video that's kind of reminiscent of this. It's played a lot differently. And Joe's kind of playing these sus2 voicings, and he even kind of stretches even further to these minor shapes. And it's really cool. It's a great picking and fingering workout, a good warm-up, or just a cool thing to kind of play around with, like this. Something like that. And you can see it starts with this D sus 2 here. And then he answers that with another D sus 2 way up here. And then he just starts kind of cascading down, like that. And then move down to A sus 2 and do the exact same thing. And then you have E minor right here. And then E sus 2 right here. F sharp minor, and then F sharp sus 2, and then G sus 2 right here. Go back to D sus 2, and then E minor right here, and then you've got E sus 2 right here, and then B minor. B sus 2. And it keeps going after that, but I kind of stopped right there because when I first kind of learned this and put it together, I decided to use it as an exercise. So I like stopping right there on B and then just start over again on D and go through the whole thing again, like this. Working on things like that where it's melodic and it's kind of, you know, a stretch, and you're definitely working on kind of fanning those fingers out and waking up your fretting hand, and you've got some picking happening there, and it's pretty demanding. Even though it sounds, you know, kind of dreamlike and simple, it's really, you know, pretty hard to play. That's going to wrap this episode with three Joe Satriani licks from 1987. And it should be pretty obvious, once again, I'm a big Satriani fan. I've learned a lot of his music, and I've learned a lot from his music. And a lot of the lessons and articles, you know, he's had in guitar magazines over the years are just, you know, packed full of all kinds of useful, you know, nuggets of information and practice ideas, warm-up exercises, you know, scales and arpeggios and all this stuff. Chords, his chord vocabulary is massive. And I have done two chord play episodes, you know, based around Joe Satriani, the chords of Joe Satriani, and also the tapped chords of Satriani too. And there's a ton of things you can learn from this, you know, pioneering, legendary, you know, guitar instructor to the stars, instrumental, you know, rock god or whatever. I mean, he's definitely a powerhouse player, and you can learn a lot, you know, whether it's the otherworldly kind of, you know, outer fringe, you know, kind of weird things that he plays, and then he has all that kind of rootsy, you know, raw rock and blues kind of stuff, and just, you know, tons of things. He's got funk and all these different things that he's thrown out. You know, great, you know, exciting musician, great player, you know, super nice guy too. And I've seen Satriani live a couple times, and he always puts on a great show. So anyway, leave some feedback and some comments. Please subscribe to Limelight Lessons, and I'll be back before you know it with more content and material. Thank you.